Hello everybody, happy Tuesday. I'm pretty excited. Today we're rolling out some cool features on buildamodule.com and I just wanted to give you a quick tour of it. The past couple of months we've begun the process of transcribing the entire video library on buildamodule.com. That's over 42 hours of video at this point. So it's taking a while, we're about 20% of the way through, but by having a textual version of the videos on buildamodule, it's allowing us to do some really interesting things. So I wanted to begin giving you the tour. So the first thing that we've been able to do is add captions. So what I'm gonna do is go ahead and click on one of the videos to begin playing it. And you'll see that every video that's been transcribed has this little CC button at the top. And it's grayed out when closed captioning is turned off. And when you click it, it will turn closed captioning on. And you'll see the text at the bottom of the video. So as we play through this video, you'll see that text change and it lines up with the text that's being spoken as closed captions do. The closed captioning not only opens up the videos to the hearing impaired, but it also allows those that are following along that might not be familiar with some of the terminology to have a backup so they can easily see what's being spoken on the screen. When the closed caption button is highlighted, you'll also see if you scroll down to the videos, a purple border next to each video that's been transcribed. So you see that not everything has been transcribed, as I said before, about 20% so far. So if you only want to target videos that do have the closed captioning, you can just select the ones that have the purple border. Okay, I'm gonna scroll back up here. The second thing that having a transcript of the videos is allowing us to do is to provide a search to allow us to search within videos. So I'm gonna go ahead and go to the top of the page here. Some of you may recognize this search form. Before, it just searched the titles of the videos. But now, we're going to be able to search the inside of the videos as well. When we get to the search page, we'll see that there's two sections. The first is for title matches, kind of like what we had previously. We see the name of the video, the collection, and the chapter that it's inside of. And then the second section is transcript matches. And this short bit of text here will tell you how much of the videos are being searched currently. Right now we have 20% of the videos transcribed and this number will continue to grow. If we scroll down, we'll see a list of the matches and you'll see the terms that you searched for highlighted in the result. And this is the text that's actually being spoken inside of the video. Now, if we wanted to jump to this particular point in the video, the time is right here, so it's out about a minute 20 into the video. We can go ahead and click on this, and it will load up the page for that video and jump us to the specific point where that text is being spoken. So we have closed captioning on here, and it's loading it at this particular point, a minute 20, you see it right here, and you see the text that you saw in the search being spoken as we're watching it. Now keep in mind that because not everything has been transcribed, we're only searching a small subset of the videos right now, but this will improve over time. Okay, so the second set of tools are available to members only. I'm gonna go ahead and log in. I'm gonna click log in and fill in my information here. And once we're logged in, I'm gonna go to the video library. Let's go ahead and jump to one of the videos. I'm going to click on this tips for watching the videos. Now you see over here, there's a sidebar that's loading called transcript. And when the video loads, I'm going to go ahead and pause it. You see that we have the entire transcript of the video available for reading in a way that's not tied in like closed captioning is to what's currently being spoken. So you can easily see what's just been said by looking at the before section, and you can easily see what's coming up by looking at the after section. And the part that's currently being spoken is highlighted in purple. Now, not only can you read through the entire transcript, see I can scroll through the entire thing so you can see the scope of what's being talked about, you can also click on any point in the transcript in order to jump to that point in the video. Right now the video is paused, and so when we click on an item, it'll jump to the screen where this text is being spoken. And this provides an alternative way to interact and learn from the video. Instead of just watching it and having it narrated for you, you can easily read through it and jump to certain points to see what the screen looks like at the particular point where the text is being spoken. Each line that's being spoken inside of this transcript view is also a link, so you can right-click it and select Copy Link Location, and if we opened up a new tab and pasted in the URL, you would see that there's a query at the end of the URL that says seconds equals 58, and this will jump us straight to that point where that particular text is being spoken. So if we wanted to save it or share it with somebody else, we can easily do that by copying the URL. Okay, I'm going to close this tab and jump back to our original tab. Now, one thing that's a little hard with the types of videos that these are is that this is a pretty small screen, and so using the screen as screenshots to follow along with text as you read it is a little hard. But you can use this large screen button here, and if you click that, what will happen is it will make the screen larger. You see that we have a much larger screen here, and then the transcript gets moved down to the bottom. And it works just like it does when it's in the sidebar. You can click any point at it, you can scroll through it, and read along as you look at the screenshots. And of course, while the video is playing, I'm going ahead and starting the video playing again, it will follow along and highlight the text in purple as it's being spoken, and it will center the area where the transcript is being viewed, so you never lose your place. If you want to scroll ahead or scroll above, you can pause the video either by clicking the screen where the video is playing or by double-clicking the transcript, and that will pause it as well. So I just double-clicked it and you see that we're now paused. I'm going to go ahead and move back to small screen mode. Now, if you hover over any point in the transcript, you'll see the time that this is being spoken. So this is at 2 minutes 3 seconds. This is at 1 minute 17 seconds, for example. Now, I can't tell you how exciting this is for me, because the one thing that's always kept me from really feeling like video is the best possible way to learn is the fact that it's really hard to use as a reference. So this really opens that up. And while this transcript view is nice, it's really just a start. We'll be adding some new features that will allow you to easily work through the content in a way that's kind of alternative to the video as we move forward in the feature set. But for now, this should give you some tools to easily use the videos as reference, not only just for the initial learning process. I hope you really enjoy these new features. If you have any feedback, please send me it. I would love to hear what you think about these, if there's anything you'd like added, any reasons you see this being particularly useful to you, anything. Just go ahead and let me know. All right, thanks a lot and have a great week.